Digital video sucks at reproducing color, and it's honestly a miracle I'm not purple in my videos. More after this intro. So there's a lot of steps that light has to go through before it can be recreated on your display, from capture to encoding to compression, and each of these steps can have a big impact on the colors in a video. And this video is going to explain what happens in each of those processes. It all starts with your camera sensor. See, in a digital camera sensor, each individual photosite, the points that capture light and become pixels, is only capable of capturing how bright something is. They can't see color. In order to capture color, cameras have what's known as a Bayer filter, named after inventor Bryce Bayer, which filters light so each pixel only sees the red, green, or blue spectrum of light, which allows a camera to recreate color. What that means is that while your camera is capable of capturing 100% of the luminance information in the image, it's capturing less color information. Only 50% of the green and 25% of the blue and red is captured. The rest of the color information is estimated when the video is encoded using a process called debayering. Most of the time, this is done inside your camera, but if you shoot raw, it happens when you process the raw video. There are cameras with other solutions to this problem, like 3CCD cameras, which have 3 sensors and use prisms to split the light, but effectively every camera, including high-end cinema cameras, use a Bayer filter. Cameras can get away with Bayer filtering because our eyes are actually less sensitive to color differences than they are to light differences. You'll notice that's a theme in this video. So now that you've got the video captured, it has to be encoded into a readable video format. Typically, that's into a format known as Y-gamma-CBCR, which is a color space. Sort of. Y-gamma-CBCR processes information from an absolute RGB color space, for example, Rec. 709. I won't get into the technical details of how that happens. There's a Wikipedia article if you really want to get into it, but essentially all the color information in a scene has to be contained inside a color space, which Y-gamma-CBCR reads from. If a captured color exceeds that color space, it's clipped in the same way that a scene can clip if it's too bright. The color will be crushed and appear the same. But hold on to your horses, because it gets even better once we compress the video thanks to a process known as chroma subsampling. This is another process that takes advantage of our eyes' lack of color sensitivity by further reducing color information without reducing luminance resolution. Chroma subsampling takes a group of pixels, typically 8 pixels in a 4x2 grid, and reduces the color information within that grid. The numbers you often see on cameras or compression formats like 444, 422, and 420 refer to the amount of chroma subsampling. The first number of the 3 refers to how wide your pixel grid is, but it's basically always 4, so you don't have to worry about that number. The second number tells you how many unique color regions are in the first row, and the second tells you how many unique color regions are in the second row. With 444, you have 4 unique color regions in the top row and 4 in the bottom, meaning you have full color resolution. 422 cuts that in half by giving you only 2 unique regions in the top row and 2 in the bottom row. This cuts your horizontal color resolution in half, but it does retain the full vertical chroma resolution. 420 goes even further with only 2 unique color regions, meaning you have half the vertical and half the horizontal chroma resolution, but again, you do maintain full luminance resolution. There are other chroma subsampling patterns like 411 or 440, but the 3 I already talked about are essentially the only ones that you'll run into in the real world. Okay, so by this point, you can probably see why it's basically a miracle that digital video has even marginally accurate colors, and I haven't even gotten into things like camera color science or display color accuracy. But I want to stop there and get into what all that information actually means for you on a practical level. So picture this, you're watching the latest action blockbuster online. It's nighttime, the hero is driving around in his kick-ass Dodge Charger. But wait, why are those bright red taillights so pixelated, even though the rest of the scene looks pretty good? Well, it's because of all that color compression that's been happening to the signal, and now it's being compounded by a bright color up against a dull, differently colored background. This is pretty common in lots of situations, especially with red. Taillights and headlights, neon lights on the street, party lights, all those bright colors can get absolutely wrecked by various color compression methods. So if you're someone who makes videos, what can you do to compensate? Well, the best thing to do is to tone down colors when color grading. you could go to the extreme, you've probably noticed I have for this video, but if you want a more subtle effect, then a hue versus saturation curve is a great tool. It's a tool that lets you selectively reduce the intensity of different colors in order to reduce the potential for them to pixelate on the edges. A lot of people who color grade try to get the best looking image possible, and that's not a bad thing. Bright colors against a background do look stunning, but you have to remember the technical side of color grading as well so you don't end up with pixelated and blurry video. Anyway, that's it for this video. If you liked this video, if it helped you, if you learned something new, hit that like button. If not, feel free to hit the dislike button. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those down in the comment section down below. And of course, if you want to see more videos like this, please hit that subscribe button.